Let's begin this newscast with a big development coming in from Nepal as Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Nepalese counterpart KP Sharma Oli are likely to talk soon as Nepal's law minister tabled an amendment bill in the parliament to give legal backing to the country's new map. Now, the Nepalese government has approached a map which shows Indian territories as part of Nepal. The contentious map, which has ignited a row between Kathmandu and New Delhi, shows Indian territories of Kala Pani, Lipu Lake and Limpia Dhura as part of Nepal. This is the big development. The bill has received constitutional backing. And now we are being told that Prime Minister Modi and Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli of Nepal will soon be holding talks. Remember, these three territories are Indian territories between the Nepal-India-China tri-junction, and now Nepal is representing them, is going to represent them on its map, for which the country has passed a bill in its lower parliament and has received constitutional backing. For more details and perspective, let's quickly go across to our principal diplomatic correspondent Siddhant Sibbal, who's joining me live from New Delhi and brings me all the details. Siddhant, the amendment bill has been tabled after much delay. Why so, and what happens now?
Well, Akanksha, the bill has been presented in the Nepali parliament, the lower house of the Nepali parliament, the House of Representatives, and now it will be discussed, debated inside the parliament, and expect around 1 week's time before the approval comes in the lower house. And then, of course, from the lower house, it goes to the upper house of the Nepali parliament. And then once the president of Nepal signs it, then it becomes a law giving a constitutional and a legal backing to the map, which was announced by the Nepali government, which showcases Indian territories as Nepali territories. The dispute basically is just not just 2 or 3 days old or 2 or 3 months old. In fact, it is more than 100 year old dispute after the Treaty of Singhalai, which was signed in 1850. It was decided that the border between the British India and Nepal will be River Mahakali on the eastern side. What Nepal says is that the British mischievously changed the border. Mm-hmm. Of course, the big question arises, why suddenly Nepal has woken up to this entire the border issue after 100 years. And if it has to be raised, then of course, countries in the Indian subcontinent can raise the issue and say that let's go and redefine the border before the British era.
Right. So it does seem like the bill will receive constitutional backing under all probability. But now, even though India's MEA has already stated that artificial enlargement of territorial claims will not be accepted by India, when should we expect official talks between the two heads of states, Prime Minister Modi and Prime Minister Oli?
Well, if we look at what is happening right now, I've spoken to sources both here in Delhi and Kathmandu. Sources are saying that both sides are keen to talk at the Prime Minister level. The Indian Prime Minister and the Nepali Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli are expected to talk. But it only depends on, of course, the schedule. But also, once the talks happen, there will be an official confirmation because the situation is delicate. Mm-hmm. Of course, the Nepali side to have foreign secretary level talks between both the Indian side and the Nepali side to resolve any border issue. But the big question is the fact that right now COVID crisis is something that is the dominating issue. And the Indian side has also said that they're open to talks, but it depends on positive and conducive atmosphere created by the Nepali side, clearly indicating that by presenting the bill inside the parliament and going through this entire legal process, this is something that is going to irk New Delhi and to create the positive atmosphere. It is up to the right. Nepali government, the Nepali court, when it comes to taking a formal step in making sure that atmosphere is positive for any talks.
Right, so the timing, of course, indeed is crucial, as you just mentioned. But the latest conflict between India and Nepal has been triggered after India announced the completion of a link road to Lipu Lake. So be it Nepal or even China, why are these two countries threatened by India's infrastructural projects that are well within the country's territory?
Well, when it comes to Nepal, this is something that the Nepali Prime Minister has raised, and of course the timing of it is something that is questioned. We know that the Indian Army Chief has said that Nepal has done it at the behest of someone. No guessing who the person is or who the country is, which in the present case is China. But when it comes to China, China will be visibly not very happy about the infrastructure projects by the Indian side on the on the LAC of the Indian side of the LAC, primarily because it disturbed the status quo for the Chinese, because the Chinese have been developing or upgrading the infrastructure, but when India does it, it's a threat perception for them. So there are different cases, but by and large, coming at the same point by both Beijing and Kathmandu.
Right, Siddhant. Thank you so much for bringing us all those latest developments on this new story. We'll keep coming back to you as and when more developments happen. But now, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has also addressed the nation earlier today through his monthly radio program, Mann Ki Baat. In his address, Prime Minister Modi said that India is leading the fight against COVID-19. Let's listen into what the Indian Prime Minister said.
Log ab in local products ko hi khareed rahe hain aur vocal for local ko promote bhi kar rahe hain. मेक इन इंडिया को बढ़ावा मिले इसके लिए सब कोई अपना अपना संकल्प जता रहा है. धीरे धीरे उद्योग भी चलना शुरू हुआ है, यानी अर्थव्यवस्था का एक बड़ा हिस्सा अब चल पड़ा है, खुल गया है. ऐसे में हमें और ज्यादा सतर्क रहने की आवश्यकता है. दो गज की दूरी का नियम हो, मुंह पर मास्क लगाने की बात हो सके तो वहां तक घर में रहना हो, ये सारी बातों का पालन, उसमें जरा भी ढिलाई नहीं बरतनी चाहिए. साथियों, हमारे डॉक्टर्स, नर्सिंग स्टाफ, सफाई कर्मी, पुलिस कर्मी, मीडिया के साथी, ये सब जो सेवा कर रहे हैं, उसकी चर्चा मैंने कई बार की है. मन की बात में भी मैंने उसका जिक्र किया है. सेवा में अपना सब कुछ समर्पित कर देने वाले लोगों की संख्या अनगिनत है. सेवा भाव से लोगों की मदद कर रहे ऐसे सभी लोगों की मैं प्रशंसा करता हूं, उनका आदर करता हूं, उनका तहे दिल से अभिनंदन करता हूं.